What's up? Welcome to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you the 5 types of photos every hairstylist should have on their Instagram page. So stay tuned. Fun one, because we are diving deep into Instagram strategy, and I wanted to share with you the 5 types of photos you as a hairstylist need to have on your Instagram page. Now, chances are, if you're watching this video, you're probably a hairstylist using Instagram to grow your business, and you might be wondering why things aren't working well for you, or maybe why you're not seeing the success you see other hairstylists having with Instagram. And so I wanted to dive deep into some of the things that you might actually be missing on your Instagram page, because you probably aren't posting these types of photos, and I think that this video is going to significantly help you. But before we get started, if this is our first time hanging out, my name is Jamie Dana, and I help hairstylists grow a business they absolutely love using Instagram, and I share lots of strategies here on this YouTube channel, as well as some hair techniques and advice there too. So let's just dive in. So you might be wondering, well, why do I need to add different types of photos to my Instagram? And here's the deal. If you're just posting hair photos on your Instagram page and your Instagram page looks like this, then chances are you're missing out on a lot of potential clients, because at the end of the day, if your page is just hair photo after hair photo after hair photo, when somebody new lands on your page, there's no reason for them to click the follow button, because at the end of the day, they know exactly what you're gonna post next. Another hair photo. And chances are you look like every other stylist and salon out there, and our goal is to help you stand out on Instagram so that you can start attracting more of the right kind of clients and they actually click the follow button. Because if they click onto your page and they don't click the follow button, you just missed out on a potential client. So what we have to do is we have to get them to click the follow button in the first place so that we can start to chat with them, talk with them, and help them to get to know, like, and trust you so that ultimately they book an appointment with you. So this comes down to adding personality to your Instagram page. And so instead of just posting hair photo after hair photo, I'm gonna be sharing with you guys 5 different types of photos that you need to be sharing on your page so that your page looks vibrant and looks fun, and it actually gets people to click the follow button, and it helps them to get to know you even better so that hopefully they'll actually book an appointment with you. Okay, so the first type of photo you should have on your Instagram page is hair photos. And you might be saying, wait, Jamie, didn't you say not to post hair photos or not to post only hair photos? Here's the thing, you don't wanna only post hair photos, and chances are if you're watching this video and you're feeling like Instagram isn't really working for you, you're not getting clients, you're not getting followers, you're not getting engagement, it's probably because you're posting a lot of the same thing, hair photo after hair photo. Now, it's still important to show off your work, but we wanna make sure that we're not posting the same kinds of hair photos, like front, back, side. We wanna switch it up, so adding in hair photos that add personality, maybe close-up photos, photos of your clients playing with their hair, hands in the hair, adding accessories, adding a braid, styling the hair in different ways, doing something a little bit different so that it's not the same kind of hair photo over and over and over again. So first type of photo that you need to be sharing is definitely hair photos, but not just any hair photos. Hair photos that have personality added into them. The second type of photos that you want to be showing is photos of your salon or photos of the space that you work in. Now, a lot of times when a client lands on your page, they want to see what they're stepping into. Now, if they don't know what to expect walking into your salon or space that you're working at, they don't really feel very comfortable. And we wanna make our clients feel really comfortable, especially potential clients who have never been to our space before. So we wanna show little details of our salon, make them feel like they've been there, show them the amazing space that you work in. So whether or not you work in a big salon or you work at a home salon or you have a salon suite, whatever the case might be, show photos of your station, photos of the shampoo area, photos of the salon in general, close-up photos of your station. give that potential client a little sneak peek of what they can expect when they come in for their appointment with you. This is gonna make them feel a lot more comfortable walking into the salon. And one thing I think we forget so often is clients are nervous coming to get their hair done. They've never met you before, they don't know what to expect, they've never been in the space. And so by showing little sneak peeks on your Instagram page, not only is it gonna add personality to your page and kind of round out your page, but it's also gonna give them a little sneak peek of what they can expect. And I would not doubt that when a potential client lands on your page, they're gonna skip a lot of your hair photos and they're gonna go to those salon photos so that they can kind of get a vibe of what they're going to walk into when they book an appointment with you. The third type of photo that you need to be sharing is photos of you. I can't tell you how many hairstylist pages I have landed on, and there's not a single photo of them anywhere on their page. Their profile photo is a photo of hair, and they have never posted a photo of themselves. How are potential clients supposed to get to know you, like, and trust you if they've never seen a photo of you? So you have to post photos of yourself. This could be a selfie, this could be a photo maybe in your photo area, this could be a photo of you and your partner, you and your kids, just a photo of you. We want potential clients to know who you are. And so you don't need to overthink this. Obviously we want this to go with your Instagram page, we want this to look professional. I don't want you posting a bunch of MySpace photos, okay? So avoid things like that. But we wanna make sure that we're just showing up on our page. And so typically what I recommend is in your first top 9 photos, the first photos that show up on your page, there should be at least one photo of you. And I'll talk about this in a second. There's other ways to incorporate this, but your potential clients need to know what you look like because they can start to create that emotional connection with you. So photos of you are so important. The fourth kind of photo that you need to be posting is photos of you working. So in the last one, I talked about just photos of you, like selfies or photos of you and your partner traveling, whatever. This actually, we wanna share photos of you in the salon, working on a client, shampooing a client, styling someone's hair, photos of you mixing color. And these don't necessarily need to be like professional shots. We'll talk about that in a whole another video, but maybe a photo that some of your coworkers take of you or something that you use with a self timer. I've done tons of photo shoots in my salon with a self timer of me mixing color. I had my assistant take some shots of me. It doesn't need to be super complicated. Again, we wanna make sure that we're looking professional, but I don't want that to hold you back. I would rather you be sharing photos of yourself on your Instagram because again, that's going to give that client that little sneak peek of what the appointment's gonna look like. And clients love seeing the behind the scenes. They don't wanna always see this perfect, curated, only hair type of thing. They want to know what to expect. They wanna see a little glimpse into their potential appointment with you. So show photos of you working, so important. And stay tuned. In the next couple weeks, I'm actually gonna be sharing a YouTube video all about how to actually get professional photos of you working, how to set up a brand photo shoot, and all the details there. So that'll be an upcoming video, so stay tuned. And if you're watching this a couple weeks later, chances are I've already linked it down in the description box below, so go check it out there. That video is gonna really break that down for you, but I wanted to create a separate video for it because I wanted to go a lot more in depth, so definitely check out that video. And last but not least, the fifth type of photo that you need to be sharing on your Instagram is either stock photos or product photos. And the reason why you should be sharing photos like this is it helps break up your Instagram feed to add in a little bit more personality. The cool thing about sharing product photos is you're able to talk about the different products that maybe your salon offers or different retail services that you might offer. So that's something that's really great. You can take these with your iPhone, you can set them up in your salon. Again, another way to incorporate salon photos is to take those product photos as well. Just take a couple products off the shelf, take a few photos. Another thing could be stock photos. And so, if you guys don't already know, I have a membership called the Social Suite. And inside the Social Suite, every single month, you get stock photos specifically designed for hairstylists. And so, what you're gonna see with these kind of stock photos, I'll show some of them here for you guys. but you're gonna see things like scissors, color bowls. You're gonna just see little bits of pieces of content that you can share on a regular basis. And so the cool thing about this membership is they come out every single month, you get brand new ones, and you get different content that, first off, you don't have to take, you don't have to create all of these setups, buy all these props, get everything set up. They're literally delivered directly to you. So you just download them and then you can use them on your page. So that's gonna save you time, but it's also gonna add that personality to your Instagram page. And it's gonna help everything look really cohesive because these photos are designed specifically to fit your brand. They're non-branded, meaning there's no different product lines in there. They're all very neutral, and they're gonna really help you set up your Instagram page so that, again, clients can start to understand a little bit more of your brand, see that cohesive page, and when they land on your page, they're gonna see a lot more personality versus like that screenshot I showed of just hair photos. If you're wondering how to incorporate these kind of stock photos into your page, I wanted to share with you guys some screenshots of some of our Social Suite members' Instagram pages and how they incorporated our Social Suite photos into them so that you can see, look how much personality they have on their Instagram page. If I landed on their page, I would definitely click, I would scroll to see more, and chances are I'd probably click that follow button. And that is our goal, for people to click the follow button, start to get to know you, start to see your personality, and ultimately to book with you. Now, I know that this whole video is all about types of photos that you should be posting, but one other thing I wanted to mention with the Social Suite is not only do you get the stock photos, but you also get caption templates. So if you've ever struggled with what to write for captions or how to write strong captions that get people to book appointments or get people to engage with you, every single month you're also gonna get caption templates and prompts delivered directly to you. So no more of the days of having to think of captions or writing lame captions like blonde balayage or caramel macchiato balayage, which, by the way, will not get clients to book with you. These captions are written in a way to help clients to actually book with you and help them to get to kind of know you, to educate your clients, and ultimately to get them to engage with you. So if you're curious about the Social Suite, we only open up the membership a couple times a year. So when you're watching this video, when it's released, we're gonna be opening it up in just a couple weeks. So if you're wanting to get some more information about the Social Suite and how you can join, we only open the doors to the membership a couple times a year. So what you can do is you can click the link below, I'll link it down below. There is a waitlist page. And so you get on that waitlist page, you enter your email, and you're gonna be the first person to know when we open the doors again. And if you're watching this video when it's first released, I'm actually opening the doors in a couple weeks. So stay tuned for that. Get on the waitlist, make sure that you enter your email because I will send you an email to let you know all the information about what the pricing is, how you can get in, and everything that comes with it. But that's really gonna save you so much time when it comes to your Instagram because you have content delivered directly to you. And again, it's also gonna add in a lot more personality to your Instagram page. And one last shameless plug I wanted to mention, if you like this kind of content, Instagram related stuff, and you want to know more, not only do I have the Social Suite membership that is delivered content, those caption templates and stock photos, but I also have a complete online course called Oh Hot Gram. And the online program is not open right now, but again, you can get on the waitlist for that as well. Go ahead, I will link that down below. And if you wanna get on the waitlist there, you can get some more information at that link. You can also get on the waitlist to get notified when we open the doors. Now with that one, we only open the doors twice a year at this point. So be ready for when we open the doors because we only open them for a short time. And if you wanna get on it, you wanna get more information of videos like this. We go really in depth, step by step, showing you exactly what you should be posting on your Instagram, sharing with you how to create content, how to make your page look really cohesive, how to take amazing photos of your clients that show off your work, everything from the algorithm. I mean, literally it is jam-packed. It's almost like a college course, but obviously way more fun. Jammed into an online program. You can get all the information at the link below. Get on the waitlist if you're interested in that. And if you're really wanting to take your business to the next level as a hairstylist, wanting to see that growth with your Instagram, this program is gonna be for you. So make sure to get on the waitlist and make sure to be notified because I will be sending you an email when all the details get released. So I hope that this video was helpful for you. And one thing that I want to challenge you to do is start to incorporate these five different types of photos into your Instagram page. And if you incorporate them, not necessarily hair photos, but the rest of them, tag me in these posts, send me a DM, let me know that you're incorporating these types of photos in your page, because I'd love to like them, I'd love to go leave you a comment, and I'd love just to see how you're doing this in your page. So please, please, please send me a DM, tag me in the photos. I just wanna connect with you on Instagram. I love doing that, and I'm excited for you to start to incorporate this stuff so that you have more personality, and hopefully so that you start to increase your following and ultimately get more clients in your chair from your Instagram. As always, if you haven't hit that subscribe button down below, make sure to do that right now. I do lots of videos every single week, and if you're a hairstylist wanting to grow your business, get better at what you do, I have content for you and I'm here to serve you. So go ahead and hit the subscribe button every single week. I'm gonna be bringing you tons of amazing videos, hair videos, business advice, lots of fun stuff coming up. So make sure to hit that button so that you don't miss anything. As always, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that it was helpful for you. I'm excited to see you implement the things that we talked about in this video, and I cannot wait to see how much you grow this year. So we'll talk soon.